treatment guidelines are a part of medical practice that is becoming increasingly essential. What these guidelines are is a formal statement of how best to choose treatments for an individual patient. Here at ASCO, what we do is have created a very formal process to create these guidelines. We have a panel of staff that carefully go through the entire medical literature to find every possible piece of information about how best to treat a certain disease. They then compile that information and they sit down with actual experts in that field, doctors who treat patients with that disease. And then the doctors review the data that the researchers have found, and between their experience and what the medical literature says is the best treatment, they come up with this very detailed plan of care. So when most patients are treated now, doctors are constantly coming up with the best plan, but always comparing it to this pathway, this written document on how best to take care of patients. What usually happens in planning the care for a patient is a meeting between the patient and the doctor, and the doctor calling upon their knowledge in general and their skill in treating people with that disease, and then trying to take the nuances of the individual that is facing cancer and trying to fit in how best to treat that person within what is known in the medical literature about how best to treat that disease. So guidelines are not exactly how you are treated. They are the knowledge base to your doctor, who then comes up with a plan of care after they meet with you and again try to understand your special needs and also what your goals for care might be. Evidence-based medicine is becoming a more and more important aspect of medical care. I think all of us, when we go seek medical care, want to know that your doctor is using the best information, the most up-to-date information. And the way that that is collected is by going to the medical literature and seeing what, with scientific rigor, has been tested and found to be true and found to be the best. So it is in some ways like a seal of approval that whatever you would choose for the care of an individual is also what would be discovered if you went and did a very extensive library investigation of what was known about that illness. Again, it's a reassurance, I think, that what your doctor's doing for you is the best and the latest care. How do people learn about these guidelines? Well, many organizations that bring together cancer experts and cancer experts in various fields of cancer care create these guidelines. And the American Society of Clinical Oncology is one group that has a very extensive experience and very extensive interest in creating these guidelines for the people that are members of our group. What we try to do is to have the information available on our website, Cancer.net. And I think that would be a very good place to start when you're trying to figure out what care is right for you based on what's known in the medical literature. One of the great things about Cancer.net is it's always created and constantly updated by specialists in the field, and not just physicians and not just medical oncologists, people experienced in radiation oncology and surgery and also other aspects of care.